Nick Palmer asking two stroke or four stroke. I would really like the four stroke more because it's really easy handling. And even though the two stroke is something old school and something really cool, I still will pick the four stroke because it's way easier and faster and better with the stars and stuff. So unfortunately for you, I still have to pick the four stroke. Lewis Dungy Arthur asking, who's your favorite rider? I'm still going for James Stewart. The guy is unbelievable on the dirt bike. He can do things nobody else in the world can. And even though he's not been running races so much anymore lately, he's still unreal. And to me, he's still the fastest guy on the planet. No, he can do things nobody else can. So big credit to that. Simon Thurlow asking for if you could ride any track in the world backwards, which one and why? Hauksund to come down the massive hill would be mine. Yeah, I think Hauksund would be an awesome track, but it's a tricky question, you know. I never can imagine any track going backwards, so it's really tough to answer, but if you like Hauksund, then I'll give Hauksund a try to race it backwards. Lee Graveson asking 450 or 350 for MX1. It's going to be a really difficult choice also for me going into the future. You know, in several of years I'll have to move up to the MX1, and I don't know yet what I'm going to race, 350 or 450, but for now I would pick the 350. Lee Head is asking, which would mean more to you, beating Everest record or winning the Essex and Open Championship in the US? I would really like to beat Stefan's record, even though racing in America would be something awesome. You know, I picked my choice and decided to race in Europe, and I've got I think 31 GP wins already, two world championship by the age of 19. So I'm on a good road to heading off to Stefan Everts' record. So I already beat one this year with winning 15 overalls in a row. So I decided going for beating Stefan Everts' record. Drew Anderson asking, what is your setup in the sand and why? I mean, the setup is pretty much the same as on the hardpack tracks. We got the same engine. Just the only thing is what's changing is the suspension. You know, our suspension in the sand is real hard because I really hit the bumps hard and the jumps. And even though the tracks are really rough, I try to go as fast as I can over it, so that the suspension needs to be hard. And with a soft suspension, I can never race as fast as with a hard suspension. So the only thing what's different is just suspension, and that's it. Favorite question is coming from Simon Thurlow asking, if you could ride any track in the world backwards, which one and why? I mean, that question is so unexpected, you know. I never thought about racing any track backwards, so it's pretty cool to come up with some crazy questions. And it's good for you guys to give attention to the motocross. You know, it's really fun, and I hope to see many of you guys here today in the dirt bike show.